Emma, would you like to put your hand up first?
First of all, the participation was excellent, and I'm happy that we all went into the breakout rooms with a great mindset. Yeah, we needed more time, but then again, the guys are going to use the document that you shared, Lisa. So quickly, we spoke about opportunities. So with the current situation, what are the opportunities that we see? And a lot of the discussions were around the gig economy, remote working, different way of working. We need to reimagine work and time and space, etc. But a few things actually stood out. One is that, thanks to Guy as well for bringing that up, is that we need to refocus on the soft skills that are required for the entrepreneur and the entrepreneurial mindset. And we need to help people to remember all of that and to retrain them on all of this and to sharpen it. Because with time, we tend to forget all of this stuff. So we forget the inquisitive mind of the child. And this is very important. So this is, he sees this as an opportunity. That's really cool. That's a different way of thinking. More opportunities are around changing the way that people think. Refocus people on seeing opportunity as well, and then to take on more risks. One of the important stuff is that there's enough opportunities for everybody in this new world order, okay? And this is one of the statements that one of our people spoke about, is that there's a lot of opportunities that are going to be created out there with what's happening. But we need to unpack all of this from a business perspective. We need to start putting on our futuristic hat and think, what opportunities I can create? Or what is this new world order creating as opportunities out there? And how can I leverage on all of that? One of the things discussed was that most of the funds are looking for tech businesses to invest in because tech is very sexy. But then again, there are other opportunities like food supply, like food security, and how to tackle all of this. How can we go beyond what is easy and comfortable? And how can we help those businesses that are doing that to go international, to go beyond South Africa and Africa, more globally? How can we think always scalable? And that's one of the things that in order to think scalable, you need to go out of your comfort zone and think differently. So from a support perspective, so we discussed, okay, these are amazing opportunities that we think are out there, but what support is required for me as an entrepreneur? And one thing clearly stood out is that we need a collaborative ecosystem. We need to plug into that ecosystem that gives me that good vibe, that brings out the best of me, that strengthens my belief in myself, gives me the drive, surrounds me with people that are creative, that have different views, different opinions, that challenge me and challenge the way that I'm doing. So my creative pathway helps me to get to where I want to get. One last thing. In order to succeed as an entrepreneur, I need to ensure that I get mentoring. I need help to move from an incubator stage to an accelerator stage. I need good connection and network. And most of all, very important, I need money, so give me financing. That's it. Thank you very much.
Oh, thank you very much to Team Emma. Lloyd, if you wouldn't mind giving feedback from your session, please.
Perfect. Thanks, Liesl. Thank you. There was definitely not enough time. I think we could spend hours unpacking this and discussing this. So I just want to apologize to my group that we had to wrap things up pretty quickly. But I think we definitely had some really good engagement and some fantastic sharing. So just to sort of pull the strings together, I think there was this sort of idea of almost finding, currently finding a sense of comfort in the discomfort. As things have been rattled, I think that's sort of part of the, you know, part of the course with being an entrepreneur is finding that comfort when things are not comfortable. And definitely this sort of, there's a strong desire or need to adapt. So as things have changed, as the winds blow a different direction, it was quite incredible listening to how, you know, some of the members in the group have sort of just rolled with the punches. And I think that's quite incredible, this need and desire to adapt. One of the guys in the group, I think it was Jared, sort of raised this great term, and it sort of came up just now with value at a distance. You know, during this time of COVID, it's so difficult to, you know, we're not engaging as we used to. And I think this idea of value at a distance is something that we really need to embrace and sort of develop from our spaces. And then this whole idea of relationships, and Emma, you were sort of touching on it in your feedback there, but this relationships are critical. And again, I think it was Jared again who mentioned this idea of free work, where he's, you know, there's a lot of giving and sharing into other spaces, not necessarily looking for anything, but they translate into opportunities. And I think through times like this, difficult times where we need to rely on each other, this, again, using those, leveraging the relationships that we have, this sort of free work and sort of can very, very often translate into the opportunity that we might not have seen before. And also just on that idea of relationships and sort of sharing this idea of bartering and trading, as opposed to sort of financial or sort of money trading, or sort of swapping a goods or service for money, this idea of barter and trade. I think that might be something which we probably see a little bit more of in various spaces. And then something which, again, Emma, I think you touched on it there, which I think is really critical during this time, is this idea of kind of getting back to basics. It's as much as there's so much going on, and we've all been pushed into the deep end with the technology, which is great, but at the same time we need to get back to the basics, and I think getting back to the basics helps give that fresh perspective, and opens that sort of clarity of mind to see the opportunities. So I just want to thank my group. Thank you for sharing, and I really hope that we have another opportunity to connect and engage further.
Thank you very much, Lloyd, and I'll talk about that moment to meet up again soon. Melissa.
Yeah, so we just captured some items here that I'll quickly go through. So people actually spoke about the opportunities and why they're doing this and becoming entrepreneurs. People said that they, you know, are addicted to the change, they are curious, they like excitement and challenges and problem solving, and they just want to have time and money freedom. And they want to be adding value to the communities in which they are operating in. And then in terms of the challenges, I think everybody had the same kind of sentiments about fear and burnout, fear of failure, being able to be vulnerable, loneliness that people have as an entrepreneur, frustration, imposter syndrome, the glass ceiling, being more self-aware or not being self-aware, and then the unconscious bias, which we've also seen come out in previous sessions that we've had. And then, also we had the courage to go full time, to take that leap and get onto the roller coaster. And then just in terms of support and things that everybody felt that that would be beneficial to entrepreneurs, we brainstormed a couple of things because we had time that was running out. And so this is what we came up with. People want to talk to other people that are experiencing the same issues. Mentorship, I know somebody else mentioned it that came up in the other group. That's what would be beneficial. Being able to talk about their frustrations, honest feedback, and having a soundboard. So lots of people said in other entrepreneurial sessions, everybody says, oh, it's great and we're all succeeding, but you know, nobody talks about the actual problems and support for their failures. And then also workshops on becoming more self-aware. So when we talk about self-aware, knowing who you are and your purpose, checking in with your purpose, those kinds of things would be of assistance. And then a tool or an app or system, maybe a process that people could be following as an entrepreneur. So yes, that's it from my side.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Melissa. Nick, you said that Liesl will give feedback, not me, another Liesl.
Lizelle will be giving some of my feedback because this is a group effort, so I didn't want to focus on.
Okay, cool. Thanks.
Lizelle.
Hello, I'm the other Liesl. I was nominated by my group to give some feedback, so here I am. Nick, please just jump in after if I've missed anything. But basically everybody, all of the other leaders have now basically, facilitators have mentioned pretty much what we've spoken about. It was a fascinating session. What I can add maybe is that although we started off from talking about the fear when this whole lockdown happened and the uncertainty and all the that fear of the unknown and everything's going to change and how it's going to look, it actually, the conversation ended up with basically, what's next? We've now adapted. We've now basically got ourselves some tech-savvy skills that we can add to our repertoire of services. And we can really just look at what is next. Now we've gotten, I know Emma, you were talking about that dopamine and that high level. And to be honest, you actually, as my, we as a group was basically also talking about how we adapted and how we, you know, adapted to the change. It also created that almost like adrenaline rush and how are we going to survive? And now it's kind of plateaued in a way where we've now gotten used to this, you know, building engagement over the screen, getting to see opportunities that are out there. Some of the AI specialists on our group were saying about the opportunities for robotics, for automation. All of those things are starting to really, it's almost that this COVID and this pandemic has really like put the spotlight on opportunities that are out there. And it's just really amplified it. So it's our mindset that we left the group with was basically, what is next? And that is so awesome to be an entrepreneur right now. Yeah, Nick, please add if I missed something.
No, I think that was beautiful. That was exactly on that point. Just to refocus is that a lot of the sentiments at the time was that this, you know, that this is the time of the whole entrepreneur, that this is their moment to shine. This is the moment to be thinking like one. This is the moment to be one. And we don't mean that this is in a like a trendy way, but we mean this in a fundamental, more human way. While we have focused a lot on the tech changes and the culture changes, the fact of the matter is that we're having more time to think about it, what it is to be more human, what it is meaning to do things more with more consciousness. And that's basically what we're trying to get to. So very well done. Yeah.
Right. I would just like to thank everybody for participating in this workshop. We are unfortunately out of time. Lessons learned here is that this is a very, very big topic for us to discuss. And I think it became very evident from the feedback that we have received that mindset has indeed become top of mind for everybody. And to emphasize again what the last team ended up with in terms of the opportunities available for entrepreneurs is extraordinary. And I'm hearing that from grade 12 students to speaking about their what next is maybe to become an entrepreneur immediately. And our entrepreneurial brain framework wants to enable the what next as well. Take you from fear to enlightenment right through to the emotion of transcending. And enlightenment is really the next step. A special thank you to these beautiful people you're seeing on your screen, Melissa, Lloyd, Emma, and Nick. Without them, we would not have been able to have done this workshop. And without you, the participants, we would not have been able to do that. So our next steps are that we will share feedback by 26th July. We will consolidate all the feedback. Please share if you have anything to contribute. Please email me at liesl@exofutures.africa and engage us on our LinkedIn community at linkedin.com/groups8931751 or just do a search, democratizing entrepreneurship by developing the entrepreneurial brain. I'll email you all of this. What we have decided is that we will hold every second week an entrepreneur virtual workshop. I think possibly an outcome from today will be, and we'll discuss that with the facilitators, is that we might unpack mindset a little bit further. So as a wrap, guys, thank you. We are looking forward to working with you as a community. And that's another important point that I think came out, that the need to work together, the support that we need to give each other. So the sense of community and tribe has become very big. And this is what we are striving to achieve with our massive transformative purpose statement in terms of, let's democratize entrepreneurship in Africa and make entrepreneurship easy for everybody. I see Lance is here, quite a few, and Jacques here, quite a few enablers that will work with us as well during this process. Stay warm if you're in South Africa. Lovely cold front has hit us. Keep safe, and we look forward to meeting up with you all again. Thank you once again.